Hey, welcome back to another Roundtable. I'm here with the cream of the air gun world. We have Rick Usler, our gun critic. We have Jim Chapman, our hunter. And of course, the godfather of air guns himself, Mr. Tom Gaylord. Gentlemen, how are we doing today?
Doing great.
Doing fine.
Good.
All right, so today I see we've got food, we've got pellets, and that makes me think big bore ammunition.
Got it.
Yeah, buddy. Absolutely.
So I think that a lot of the questions we get is when to use, what to use, and how to use it when it comes to big bore air guns. And let's be clear, at what caliber do we start calling a gun a big bore?
Well, you know, for
here
me,
comes
Tom and I have had this discussion over and
yeah,
over.
Yeah, we have.
You know, I consider 40 and above big bore, and I consider the 30s to be mid bores, but there are a lot of 30s being made now at lower power, like 100, 120 foot-pound, and they're not appropriate for big game hunting. They're fine for predators, but not for big game.
So for today's sake, let's say we're going to go 9 millimeter and up. Sorry, 30s, you're out.
Big bore is anything that's not small bore in my book.
Yeah.
You got four small bore calibers.
Put them back up there.
And your 30s are big bore.
30 are back.
What we're really discussing is not the size of the bore, but rather the power the gun has. Right. And our viewers have to understand, and hunters have to understand, it's power and not caliber that does a lot of the work until you get to a certain range of power, and then caliber starts taking over and doing more of the work.
Because only in the 30 and the 35 do you get an actual skirted pellet. So what is the difference, and why should you go from a skirted pellet to a round ball to some sort of a mold?
First, I'd say, here's a 177 pellet. That's what we're used to shooting out of our air guns. Here's a 35 caliber. I mean, that's quite a difference.
Yes, it is.
And this isn't exactly a 30 caliber. It's a 380, but there's a round ball. And you compare that to that pellet.
Right.
Okay, so obviously a large size difference. Which one's getting more penetration? Which one's getting better?
The round ball will give better penetration on game.
Okay.
Yeah, for me, it's usually not between a pellet and round ball. It's usually between a pellet and a cast bullet.
Okay.
And it depends, again, on the game. If I'm going after larger game and I'm going to be shooting at longer ranges especially, then I'll go with a cast bullet every time.
Cast bullet. And these are the cast bullets we're looking at, right? So these are not pellets. They're not round ball. They're actually cast. Basically what would be in a
firearm.
There's your 30 cast bullet.
Okay. Right. All right. So you prefer this for when?
If I'm going to be reaching out further and if I'm going after bigger animals.
Okay, so cast bullet for bigger animals and distance, round ball for more penetration and closer.
Again, round ball, I kind of lump in with the cast, but pellets are where I'm going after still bigger game, but closer. Because these don't have a ballistic coefficient as good as the bullet, so they don't carry as far.
They look like a badminton shuttlecock, and they start out fast and slow down fast.
Okay, so something we've talked about previously, if you're doing some sort of hunting, but you want to kind of minimize possible damage in your environment, something like this is good.
Right.
So this is great use for application. I want to go to you as a person who tests a bunch of guns with different ammunition. What do you see is the most consistent, let's talk about like with accuracy, stuff like that?
Big bore, I'm looking at the 30 and 35s. The guns that I've been shooting are not the 180 pound or foot-pound gun. There are the 100, 120, and those I've always found the pellet to be the better option, to be more accurate option, or the appropriately sized round ball. And depending on what the bore of the rifle is, you find the right one and just stick with it. Round ball, I
found, even within a 357 or 9mm caliber gun,
they're all over the place, yeah. No, and that's actually why the pellet, I think, is really the universal go-to, because it expands when you hit it with that air. The skirt will expand somewhat, and these are a little bit oversized to begin with.
Okay.
They're more forgiving.
So let's jump ahead. Let's move up to the 45s and above, because at that point you lose the pellet, and it's
a bullet.
Molded, or bullet essentially, or a round ball. So where would a round ball fit into this scenario?
A round ball.
Closer to the bullet than it would, to the shorter bullet than it would to the larger.
So again, if you're dealing with flat and predators.
And I've taken actually a lot of wild boar with round ball. Here's the thing with big boars that we haven't touched on yet. I mean, and we were all at the SHOT Show. Mm-hmm. The number of big boars coming out to the market is just exploding.
Yes.
And part of the reason are more states are adding laws that allow you to hunt with them. More mainstream hunters are seeing the use of these, and they want to try it.
And affordable,
and you're starting to see people come over from archery. So, especially as a guy gets older, you know, holding that 50-pound bow at a long draw while you're in the high seat, waiting for the animal to get to the right spot, it's a little bit more challenging, whereas that air rifle, you can just hold it there.
And you're still getting that kind of up-close hunting experience,
and you extend your range.
You have to hunt, you have to get in close, you have to use your field craft to get in on the animal, you have to really be a good hunter.
Well, and you're really good at it, which leads us to the snack that's in front of me. This is what? What is it? What am I looking at here?
Actually, this was a sow. We took two big pigs. One was 160 and one was 205 pounds.
What'd you take them with?
On a hunt in Texas. I was using a quackenbush and a bushbuck for the two. And anyway, we shot these pigs and brought them back, had it processed, and we've got some really good sausage here. Want to try it?
I'm getting hungry.
Yep.
Gentlemen, this is the whole reason we shoot. I don't need a fork. This is why we use and discuss the guns and the ammunition that we're talking about today, is for this right here, to get this incredible meat. Thanks, buddy. You tasted amazing.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be taking the discussion outdoors to do some really cool big bore ballistic tests.